we'll just also turn on the video. And now just for the next, let's say, few minutes, I will give you a very short overview on a new project that has been started a few months, let's say, ago, the SimEA, the ERA chair project, which actually is complementary, I would say, to the projects that we have seen before from Professor Alexandre, the EuroCC. And this is a new initiative, which, as you see from the title here, it is focusing on the computational science and engineering of complex systems and complex materials. And actually, this is a very, I would say, interdisciplinary field, because it involves, beside, let's say, physical sciences, also algorithms, of course, mathematics, computing, and all this is part of what we typically call computational science and engineering. And this is very broad. Of course, there are many different topics associated with this, and definitely it is also coupled to, I would say, large-scale computational infrastructure. So this will be based on new projects that we are going to start, and for that also the computational infrastructure, the supercomputer which is available at the institute, is of great importance. And just again to remind to everyone how important is this field, let's say, nowadays. This is part of what is called typically the third and the fourth pillar of scientific research. And typically, you all know, for thousands of years, science was merely empirical, I would say most. And then there was the huge increase of the theoretical improvement, let's say, in our knowledge. But the last 50 years, there are also two new pillars there in this scientific research. And the first is the high-performance computing, the computational branch. And the last, I would say, 10 or 20 years is also this huge advance of database methods. So this third and the fourth now pillar, let's say, of research are directly related with the computational engineering, and also, of course, with the large infrastructures. And this is now part of this new project that has been started a few months ago, as I said. Here are just some numbers, let's say, about the ERA chair. Now, what is of important for us is that this is a long-term project. Will be, as you see here, for the next 4 years, or almost 4 years. And then if you see the scope here of the SimEA, is beside, let's say, the pure scientific, which is to advanced computing methods and data-based methods in order to solve challenging engineering problems. But beside that, the main task is to create collaborative schemes with academia, public, and private sector. So it's of great interest for us to create new joint projects with the industrial sector. And not only that, but in more general, let's say, together with the EuroCC, to create a computational science and engineering hub at CaSToRC and the Cyprus Institute, which will be for the national, but also on the more global, I would say, network. And for that, as you will see later, there are also some structural changes at the level of the center and of the institute, the most important of which is the new Management and Innovation Office. There is also the web page of the project where you can find many, many more details. This is just also to give you an overview of the members of the research team, which comprise, beside myself, also from Nico Sava, an assistant professor, applied mathematician. And then there are three postdocs, Panagiota Katsaba, Petra Batsova, and Aves Mahmoud, who are working more on research projects related with the SimEA. There are also three PhD students, Nikolaos Patsalidis, Eleftherios Christofi, and Pavel Zarva. We have already started doing their PhD thesis. And besides that, now there is the Innovation Industry Scout, Christos Christodoulou. You have seen Christos in the previous presentation, but I'm sure that you will hear him a lot and during these days. So Christos is the person that is directly involved with the anticipated, let's say, collaborations between our team and the private sector. And there is also Kathy Christoforou, who is our scientific coordinator, and also it will be a contact project if you want to get any information about the project. Now, if we go a little bit more on the research direction, let's say in the themes of the project, because of course computational engineering is a very, very broad topic and complex materials as well. So the pure, let's say, or the more research-based parts of the project will be based on our previous experience or our expertise, let's say. And this is mainly related with the multi-scale computational modeling of nanostructured materials, in most of the cases polymer-based, which are very challenging materials and which we use in our daily lives. And beside the part of the application, it's very challenging also to develop new methods for that system. So this means new algorithms, new computational methods. And actually, part of these systems concern also more bio, I would say, based applications. That's why you see here the biomolecular systems. And always when we're talking about modeling, about simulations, there is many open questions related to which model we should select, what is the best model for a given problem, and if it is possible also to get, let's say, errors from them for a given model or a given problem. And all this, of course, as I said, are coupled is a coupling actually between the high performance computing and nowadays AI technologies. And as Dina mentioned before, now we're going towards the exascale era, which is really an amazing thing from the point of view of the available computational power that will be in a few years. So it's really challenging also to develop new methods to take advantage of the new infrastructure. And this is just an overview of what we typically call multi-scale modeling that involves a hierarchical, I would say, combination of different methods, starting from the most detailed, which is the quantum, up to the classical or microscopic level, to the mesoscopic, and up to the continuum approximation. So all this case, I mean, the idea is that someone should use, let's say, part or many of these methods in order to predict properties of materials or to predict, let's say, the macroscopic behavior of the material starting from the microstructure. And this is part of what we typically call computer-aided design of materials. And not only materials, but process as well. And this is the main task from the point of view of, let's say, the research development of the CIMEA. And just to give you a couple of examples, actually, it's mainly from the projects that we had so far. And a main, let's say, application area concerns polymer nanocomposites. So polymer nanocomposites are used everywhere in our daily life. Tires is the most, let's say, well-known material. But actually, if you see here, the applications are really, they belong to a very broad fields, from the information industry to environment, to energy, and to nowadays actually a lot also to the biomedical field. So in all these cases, there are polymers together with some particles, for example, and all this, the polymer nanocomposite have some, let's say, enhanced properties for a given application. And this is just now an example of what we have done, let's say, in the recent past. So this is, it's part of what we call here research experience. And that could be also, if you are coming, let's say, from an industry, that could be also an idea of what you can find for your problem. So this is a multi-scale modeling applied now on a specific problem. And the problem is to design a new tire materials with enhanced properties. And exactly the multi-scale, the idea of the multi-scale is to start from the real actual chemistry of the system and from the structure of the material, the molecular level. And then via a coupling, you don't need to follow up here this, but it's a coupling of different techniques here, different actually methodologies, to go from that up to the engineering scale, what is typically called engineering scale, which is close to the actual macroscopic scale of the real material that we see. And of course, this is something that typically involves many different methods, quite often many different groups. And this was actually, it is a project with in collaboration with Goodyear. That's a typical example. Another example of let's say, research projects of CIMEA, which are which involve actually the private sector and industries, is another from a different area, but actually again we have production and processing of polymers. So in this case, the idea is to derive and to get from bio-waste bioplastics. That's a very challenging field because, of course, the idea is to, if possible, to use instead of the synthetic, the classical synthetic plastic, which is not biodegradable, to use bioplastic, which is derived, which we can get it in principle directly from the waste, the bio-waste as we call here, and from that to derive the plastic bags, let's say. And this was a collaboration with several research institutes, but also Enviroplant, which is a leading industry in Greece, in Athens from that. And then the idea is again to start from the molecular level. So in this case, beside of course the modeling, there is also the experimental, there were experimental groups. And then you can see the whole now chain again from gathering the bio-waste to take out of that the lactic acid, then do the polymerization, which is the polylactic acid. And then via, again, using the modeling as a guide in order to improve the process, let's say, to derive the bag, and from that go to biodegradable bags, which are like that. And of course, this is circular. Actually, this is part of what we call nowadays cyclic economy, because again, of course, the bags will go to the bio-waste, and then again, this process will go back, let's say, to the circle. So these are just two simple examples of that. And that's, as a final, I would say, note again what Professor Alexandru said before, that together with the EuroCC, the idea is to create at the CaSToRC also a national competence center, not only for the computational from the computational infrastructure, let's say, point of view, but also for creating collaborations with industry, with academia, of course, as we did already, with public sector and with industry. And just now, I think this is the last part that I would like to say. So this also is coupled together with structural changes at the level of the institute. And as you see here, there is already a new office at the institute, the management and innovation. Christos is the main part of that, but also Kathy Christofora and Andreas Gavrilidis, and all of them could be contact persons in order to link, to create, let's say, links between academia, industry, and government. And this is the main idea of all this. And of course, I mean, we're already in the industry week, but there will be also, as you know, many more events. So I will stop here. Actually, as a final slide, is something that you probably seen, you will see from different talks, but this is interesting to see also. It was the first analysis from the MIO office and from Christos, especially about the market analysis in Cyprus. And as you can see here, the number of companies in Cyprus analyzing it using big data, it's really increasing dramatically during the last few years. So this is shows exactly how, let's say, important is this part and will be for the next few years. Of course, not only Cyprus, everywhere. This is just the infrastructure. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Harmandaris, for this introduction to the SimEA project. If anyone has any questions for Professor Harmandaris, please raise your hands now so we can address them. I don't see any. So thank you very much for this introduction.